And do they so? Henry Vaughan. For created things, watching the fair direct, wait the revelation of the sons of God. Do they so? Have the sense of all but influence? Can their heads lift and expect and groan too? While your leg can do no more, where William said, we were all dull and dead. They judged them senseless, and they stayed wholly in the maid. Go, go, seal up their looks, and burn their books. I would there were stone or tree, or flower, by pedigree, or some poor highway herb, or spring to flow, or bird to sing. And should I, tied to one sure state, all day expect my date? That I am sadly loose, and stray, and giddy blast each way. Or let me not thus arrange, for canst not change. Sometimes I sit for free and tarry an hour or so, then vary. By other creatures in the scenes, the only aim and mean. Some rise to seek we, with heads erect, peep from their beds. Others whose birth is in the tomb, and cannot quiet the womb, sigh there and groan for we, the liberty. Or let me not do less. Shall they watch while I sleep or play? Shall I their mercy still abuse, or fancies, or friends, or news? I brook it not, the blood is mine, and my soul should be wine. I brook it not, my will will stop after whole showers one drop. Show I will joy to see thy sheep of we. Anguish, by Henry Vaughan. My God and King, do we above my knee, above my troubled soul, and greet with my full heart thy holy feet. Cast it or treat it, it shall do even what thou wilt and praise we too. My God, could there be blood, gladly I would, if thou wilt give me but art, which through the eyes puts out the heart, I will exhaust it all, make myself all tears, a weeping lake. Oh, tis an easy thing to write and sing, but to write true, unfeigned verse is very hard. Oh, God has purged these ways and give me spirit leave to act as well as to conceive. My God, hear my cry, or let me die. As time one day by me did pass, by Henry Vaughan. As time one day by me did pass, through a large dusky glass he held, I chanced to look, and spied his curious book, of past days, where said heaven did shed a morning light upon the dead. Many disordered lives I saw, and foul records, which form my kind eyes still, but in a fair white page of thin and even smooth lines, like the sun's rays, my name was writ in all my days. A bright and happy calendar, where youth shines like a star, and pearled with tears and many, teach age the holy way, and through thick pangs, high agonies, faith into life breaks and death dies. As a meek night peace, which day quails, to candlelight unveils, so by one beamy line of a bright lamp did shine the same page for humble grave, set with green herbs, glad hopes and brave. Here's let my thoughts dear mark, which dust seem to the wooer like rust, but dust that it observe, the hiding dove preserve, as we for long and sure recruits candy of sugar or choice fruits. Our calm and sacred bed, where lies in death's dark mysteries, a beauty far more bright than the noon's cloudless light. The rose dry dust, green branches bud, and robes are bleached in the lamb's blood. Sleep, happy ashes, blessed sleep, while heartless I still weep. Weep that I have outlived my life, and unbelief must, soulless shadow, so live on, for life be dead and my joys gone. Childhood, by Henry Vaughan. I cannot reach it, my striving eye dazzles at it as at eternity. And now I chronicle alive those wide designs which children drive, the thoughts of each harmless hour, with a content to my power, quickly would I make my path even, and by my playing go to heaven. Why should men laugh, wolf within a lamb or dove, or choose hellfire and brimstone streams, before bright stars and God's own beams? Or kiss a thorns will hurt his face, but flowers to both refresh and grace, and sweetly living, fear and man. Ah, when dead, medicine and then. If seeing much should make state eyes, and long experience should make wise, and all that age doth teach us ill, why should I not love childhood still? Why, if I see a rock or shelf, shall I from whence cast down myself? Or by complaining of the world, from the same precipice be hurled? Whose observations are but fool, which make me wise to lose my soul? And yet we practice worldlings cold, business and weighty action all, checking the poor child for his play, I gravely cast themselves away. Dear harmless age, a short swift span, where weeping virtue parts with man, where love without lust dwells, and bends what way we please without self ends. An age of mysteries, which he must live twice with what God's face see, which angels guard, and with play, angels which fool men drive away. How do I study now and scan thee more when I studied men and only see for a long night thy edges and the bordering line, or for thy centre and midday, for sure that is the narrow path. Come, come, what do I hear? The hen we warn. Come, come, what do I hear? And she is gone, each day is grown a dozen year, and each hour one. Come, come, cut off the sum, a wee soil tears, which only thou knowest to be true. Days are my fears. There's not a wind can stir or beam pass by, but straight I think for father hand is nigh. Come, come, strike his lips dumb, as a restless breath that soils thy name will ne'er be tame until in death. Perhaps I think a tomb in a house of store, but a dark and sealed up womb that she ne'er breathes more. Come, come, such thoughts benumb, but there would be with him I weep, a bed and sleep to wake and wee. Content, but Henry warn. Peace, peace, I know it was brave, and as cause flees, a shelter in, a slave, to no such peace. And I am gone, show no wardrobes leave, to friend or son, but where own homes weave. Such woe nor proud nor full, may make them weep, and mourn to see the wool outlast the sheep. Poor, pious were, hadst thou been rich or fine, perhaps the tear had mourned the loss, not mine. Why, when we curled, puff points, or lace story, there sets all out of joint and scorns the glory. Some love arose in hand, some in the skin, across the woes and would have mine within. Corruption, the hand we worn, sure it was so, when was early days was not all stone on earth. He shined a little, and by was we grace at some glimpse of his birth. He saw heaven o'er his head, knew from whence he came, condemned hiver. His first love draws strongest, so from hence his mind should progress fiver. Things ye were strange unto him, sweat and till, almost a thorn or wheat. Not it was last, but like himself, died still as soon as made it seed. They seemed to crawl with him, for that act had failed and foiled them all. A view to curse upon the world, and cracked the whole frame with his fall. This made him long for home, as love to stay with murmurers and foes. He sighed for Eden, would often say, what bright days were those. Nor was heaven cold unto him, for each day the valley of the mountain afforded visits, and still paradise lay in some green shade or fountain. Angels lay lyre here, each bush and cell, each oak and highway knew them. Walk but the fields, or sit down at some well, and he was sure to view them. Almighty love, where art thou now, a madman sits down and freezeth on. He raves and swears to stir nor fire nor fen, but bits of thread be spun. I see the curtains are close drawn, the boughs and rhymes still, and men are sunk below the centre and the shroud. All's in deep sleep at night, thick darkness lies and hedged o'er my people. Hark, what trumpets wet, what angels cries, rise, thrust in the sickle. Joy of my life, where left me here, by Henry Vaughan. Joy of my life, where left me here, still my love, on thy absence thou dost stir me from above. A life well led, this truth commence, with quick or dead it never ends. Stars are of mighty use, the night is dark and long, a road full, and where one goes aright, six many go wrong. One twinkling ray shall o'er some cloud clear much away and guide a crowd. God's saints are shining lights, whose days here long must pass, o'er dark hills, swift streams, and steep ways smooth as glass. And these all night, like candles shed the beams, and light us into bed. They are indeed our pillar fires, seen as we go. They are that city's shining spires we travel to. A sword-like gleam kept man for sin, first out this beam will guide them in. Love and Discipline by Henry Vaughan. Since in the land not barren still, cause for dust thy grace is still, my lord is fallen, blessed be thy will. And since these biting frosts but kill some tars in me which choke or chill, that seed was sowed, blessed be thy skill. Blessed be thy dew and blessed thy frost, and every eye to be so crossed, curled by crosses at thy cost. The duty of cheer what is distressed, the frosts the weeds nibble molest, and both for works not the best. Was while my several mercies plot will work on me, now cold, now hot, how goes on and sacketh not. For as the hand the weather stirs, so thrive her best, twixt joys and tears, and all the year have some green ears. Midnight, Henry Vaughan. When to my eyes, while deep sleep hours catches, mine host of spies, stars shine in the watches, I do survey each busy ray and how a work can win, and wish each beam my soul doth stream with the like honored shine, for diminations, quick vibrations, and bright stirs aware, what thin ejections, cold affections, and slow motions here. Why heavens, some say, a fiery liquid light, which mingled eye streams and flames thus to the sight. Come then, my God, shine on this blood and water in one beam, and thou shalt see kindly by we both liquor burns and stream. Of what bright quickness, active brightness, and celestial flows will follow after on that water which red spirit blows. Quickness, by Henry Vaughan, for its life, a foreigner no more, and wilt thou be gone, a full deception of all men, I would not have a true come on. O art the moon like toil, a blind self posing state, a dark contest of waves and wind, a mere tempestuous debate. Life's a fixed discerning light, and knowing joy, no chance or flit, but ever bright and calm and full, yet doth not cloy. It is such a blissful thing that still doth vivify, and shine and smile half a skill to please without eternity. About a toilsome mould, or less, a moving mist, with life's what none can express, a quickness which my God hath kissed. Retirement, by Henry Vaughan. Fresh fields and woods, the earth's fair face, God's footstool and man's dwelling place. Ask not why the first believer did love to be a country liver, or to secure pure content did pitch by groves and wells' tent. I might view the boundless sky and all those glorious lights on high, the flying meteors, mists and showers, subjected hills, trees, meads and flowers, a minute bless the king and wise creator of each thing. Ask not why he did remove to happy memory a holy grove, leaving the cities of a plain to lot in a successless train. All the rise lust the cities still are found, ever frowns of ill, the dismal sinks where blood is spilled, cages with much uncleanness filled, and rural shades of sweet offence of pity and innocence. Ever meek's calm region, where angels are scanned and rule the sphere, the heaven lies lyre, and the dove duelist hue comes from above. If Eden be on earth at all, is that which we the country call. Rules and Lessons, by Henry Vaughan. And first thine eyes unveil, give thyself leave to do the like. Bodies but forerun the spirit's duty. True hearts spread and heave unto the God, as flowers do to the sun. Within the first fortune, so shalt thou keep in company all day, and in him sleep. Yet never sleep the sun, that prayer should dawn with the day. I set awful hours twixt heaven and us, when I was not good at the sun rising, far I saw these flowers. Rise to prevent the sun, sleep doves and glut, and heaven's gate opens, and his world shut. Walk for fellow creatures, note for hush, and whispers mongst them. There's not a spring or leaf, but half is mourning him, each brush and oak doth know, I am canst thou not sing. A leaf I cares and folios go his way, and void sure to prosper all the day. To heighten thy devotions and keep low mutant's thoughts, what business ever hast, to have gardens works, of fountains flow, birds sing, beasts feed fish leaf, the earth stands fast, for restless motion, running lights, vast circling azure, giddy clouds, days, nights. When seasons change, when lay before one eyes, as wondrous method, mark or various scenes in heaven, hear thunder, rainbows, snow and ice, calms, tempest, light and darkness by his means. Or canst thou admit his praise, each tree, herb, flower, and shadows of his wisdom and his power. Silence and Stealth of Days, by Henry Vaughan. Silence and Stealth of Days, the snow since thou art gone, 1200 hours, and on the brow but clouds hang on. As sieved in some cave's thick damp, looked from the light, fixed a solitary lamp to brave the night, and walked from the sun, when past gleaming grey, cuts through heavy mists and haste back to his day, so after that minutes I retreat unto that hour, which shall be last, but did defeat thy light and power, and certain drag my soul to see if was beams again, nothing but snuff to me a pair of play. A dark, and it sleeps in its known common urn, I was fled to make makers frown where shine and burn. Could I track them, but souls must track one the other, and of a spirit, not the dust, must be thy brother. Had I have one pearl by whose light all things I see, and the heart of earth and night find heaven and we. The Bird, by Henry Vaughan. High over thou comest, busy wind all night, for lodging, thy own warm wing, thy pillar was, many a sullen storm, whose cause man seems much of it are born, rain over bed and harmless hand. Now as fresh and cheerful as the light, a little hard and early homestuffs sing to the providence whose unseen arm curved them and clothed them well and warm. All things that be, praise him, had the lesson taught them when first made. So hills and valleys into singing break, and though poor stones have neither speech nor tongue, while active winds and streams have run and speak, its stones are deep in admiration. As praise and prayer you bend of the sun, make lesser mornings and greater done. For each enclosed spirit is at high, and lightning is only its sphere, whose light, of hedged and bored from afar, both mornings makes and evenings wear. And as these birds of light make a land glad, chirping their solemn matins on each tree, so the shades of night some dark foes be, whose heavy notes make all but hear them sad. The turtle then in palm trees mourns, and owls and zephyrs howl, pleasant land of brimstone turns, and all the streams grow full. Brightness and mirth and love and faith all fly, as the day spring breaks forth again from high. The book by Henry Vaughan. Eternal God, maker of all, they have lived here since the man's fall. A rock of ages, no shade, they live unseen, when here they fade. But new is this paper when it was, seed, and after that but grass. For 'twas dressed or spun, and made line, and put it word when. What were their lives, their thoughts and deeds, their good corn or fruitless weeds? When new is this tree when a green shade covered it, since a cover made, and there it flourished, grew and spread, as if it never should be dead. And new is this harmless beast when he did live and feed by thy decree on each green thing, and slept, well fed, clothed with the skin which now lies spread, and covering all this aged book, which makes me wisely weep and look on my own dust, but dust it is, not so dry and clean as this, when used in sauce to mould, and one was scattered was, dust for whimsome. O knowing glorious spirit, and woe should restore trees, beasts, and men, and woe should make all new again, destroying only death and pain, give him amongst the works a place, whom them loved and sought their face. The Call, Henry Vaughan. Come, my heart, come, my head, sighs and tears, it's now since you have lain thus dead some 20 years. Wake, wake, some pity take upon yourselves, and never wake to groan nor weep shall be sentenced for the sleep. Do but see your sad estate, how many sands have left us, where we careless sate with folded hands, what stock of nights, of days and years, and silent flights, stole by our ears, well have we ourselves bestowed, whose sons are all set in a cloud. Come and let's pursue them all, and as we pass, with sins on every minute fall, score on the glass, on way, and rain the heavy state, till the glass of tears you fill, done we shall be safe and good, for beasts were clean, which truth were cut. The dawning, Henry Vaughan. What time will thou come, and shall that cry, the bridegroom's coming through the sky, shall the evening run, and words and works are doom, will all surprising a light break at midnight when I ever sleep, or some dark pleasure possess of madman without measure? Shall these early fragrant hours unlock of our bowers, and the blush of light decry the locks crowned with eternity? Indeed, it is the only thing that is thy glory doth with Jim, will himself yield, the whole creation shakes of night, and for thy shadow looks the light. Stars now vanish without number, and pursue clouds the splendid scatter, all except some sudden matter. Beam triumphs, but of a far but morning star. Oh, at what time soever, though unknown to us, the heavens will bow, and if the angels in the van descant the judge poor careless man, grander may not like part lie in a corrupt security, where the traveller water crave, he finds it dead and in the grave. But as with the rest as thou could spring, all day and night doth run and sing, and thou here born, yet is acquaintanced elsewhere and flowing keeps untainted, so let me all my busy age and thy free services engage. And what will here force I must have commerce as sometimes with poor dust, my flesh for wild and low as the stealth and channel flower, and let me cause my aim, my love, and chief acquaintance be above, so in a day and hour shall come, in which myself will be the sun, will find me dressed and on my way, watching the break of thy great day. The Dwelling Place by Henry Vaughan. What happy secret fountain of fair shade or mountain, whose undiscovered virgin glory boasted this day, though not in its story, was went by dwelling. Did some cloud fixed to tend this candor shroud, my distressed lord, or did the star beckoned by we, or high and far, and sparkling smiles haste gladly down to lodge light and increase our own? My dear, dear God, I do not know what lodge do when, nor where, nor how, but I am sure thou hast now come off to a narrow, homely room, The world was but the least part, by God, I mean my sinful heart. The incarnation and passion by Henry Vaughan. Lord, when the world is my self-undress, laying by the robes of glory to make us more, I would be less and becomes the woeful story. To put on clouds instead of light, and cloth a morning star with dust, or scintillation of such height as but in we was ne'er expressed. Brave warmth and earth, that thus could have a God enclosed within yourself, you make a pendulum in a grave, life locked in death, heaven in a shell. My dear Lord, what couldst thou spy in this impure, rebellious clay, that made me was resolved to die, those would kill thee every day? Or what strange wonders could we move, to slide thy precious blood and breath? Sure it was love, my Lord, for love is only stronger far than death. Pursued by Henry Vaughan. Lord, what a busier is this thing has for made man. Each day and hour, he is on wing, rests not a span. Having lost the sun and light by clouds surprised, he keeps commerce in the night with air disguised. Hence forgiven to his active dust, the state and tired, the lost sun had not left for husk, nor home desired. It was thy secret, and it is thy mercy too, when all fails to bring to bliss, and this must do. A Lord, and what a purchase will it be, to take us sick, that some will not take we. The Shepherds, by Henry Vaughan. Sweet, harmless lives, whose holy leisure waits innocence and pleasure, whose leaders to those pastures and clear springs, the patriarchs, saints, and kings, who happened it that in the dead of night you only saw true light, the Palestine was fast asleep, and lay the vote what a fault of day. Was it because was first and blessed swains, the pilgrims on those plains, and they received the promise which no, twas where first shown to you? Tis true, he allows for dust so on we go, but serve him here below, and wherefore might for memory of woes his love at first disclose. When wretched Salem once his love was known, no voice, no vision, no, a state he piles of all the height and pride, who languished and died, and Bethlehem's humble courts above him stepped, when all her seers slept. His cedar fair, its downs and gold were all polluted through the fall, and those once sacred mansions were no mere emptiness and show. This made the angel call and reeds and fetch, yet where the shepherds watch God's own lodging, for he could not lack to be a common wreck. No costly pride, no soft-clothed luxury in woes and cells could lie. Each stirring wind and storm blew through their cots, which never harbored plots. Only content and love and humble joys lifted without all noise. Perhaps some harmless cares for the next day did in their bosoms play, as where to lead the sheep, what silent nook, what springs the shades to look, but red was all, and now with gladsome care we for the town prepare, we leave the flock, and a busy talk, all towards Bethlehem walk, to see the South's great shepherd, who was come to bring all stragglers home, where now we find him out, and fall before the Lamb of God at door, that Lamb whose days great kings and prophets wished, and longed to see but missed. First light we beheld was bright and gay, and turned their night to day, but to this later light they saw in him, the day was dark and dim. The Storm, by Henry Vaughan. I see the youth, now my blood is not a sea, but a shallow, bounded flood, or red as he. It ever flows, as strong as his, and boiling streams and rave, with the same curling force, and hiss, as doth a mountain wave. And when his waters billow us, dark storms, and wind inside them to with fierce discuss, else not inclined, as the enlarged, enraged air, uncalms these to a flood. But still the weather that's most fair breeds tempest in my blood. Lord, when round me with weeping clouds, and let my mind in quick blasts I bend for shrouds, a spirit wind, so shall that storm purge this recluse, which sinful ease made fool, and wind and water to thy use, with wash and wing my soul. The Timber, by Henry Vaughan. Sure it did flourish once, and many springs, many bright mornings, much dew, many showers, passed overhead. Many light hearts and wings, which now are dead, lodged in their living bowers. And still a new succession sings and flies. Fresh groves grow up, and the green branches shoot towards the old and still enduring skies, for the low violet thrives at their root. But woe beneath the sad and heavy line of death, doth waste all senseless, cold and dark, where not so much as dreams of light may shine, nor any thought of greenness, leaf or bark. And yet as if some deep hate and dissent bred in thy growth betwixt high winds and thee, were still alive, or does great storms resent before they come, and knowest how near they be. Else all at rest for liest, and the fierce breath of tempests can no more disturb thy ease. At this thy strange resentment of death meets only woes who broke, and life thy peace. The True Christians, by Henry Vaughan. I stick up ivy in the base, and restore the heaven ways. Green will remind you of a spring, whose great day denies the thing, and mortifies the earth and all, with your wild revels and loose haul. Could you wear flowers and roses strow, blushing upon your breast's warm snow, and there you dress your lightness with a rebuke, and wither at the ear. The brightness of this day we owe not unto music, mask, nor show, nor gallant furniture, nor plate, but to the manager's mean estate. His life will hear, as well as birth, was but a check to pomp and mirth, and all men's greatness you may see, condemned by his humility. When leave your open house and noise, to welcome him with holy joys, and the poor shepherd's watchfulness, whom light and hymns from heaven did bless. What you abound with, cast abroad, to those that want and ease your load. Where empties thus the bring more in, but riot is both loss and sin. Dress finely what comes not in sight, when you keep your Christmas right. Unprofitableness, by Henry Vaughan. How rich, O Lord, how fresh her visits are. Twas but just now my bleak leaves hopeless hung, sullied with dust and mud. Each snarling blast shot through me, and it shared the youth and beauty, cold showers nipped, and wrung their spiciness and blood. But since thou didst in one sweet glance away their sad essays, I flourish, once more breathe o'er perfumes and spice. I smell at you like myrrh, and all the day were my bosom a full sun. Such a star hath one beam from my eyes. But ah, my God, what fruit hast thou of this? What one poor leaf did ever I yet fall to wait upon the riff? Thus woe all day, your fang the sweet to stress, and when 'twas done, a stench of fog is all the odour I bequeath. Wane wits and eyes, by Henry Vaughan. Wane wits and eyes, leave and be wise. Abuse not, shun not holy fire, out of true tears, wash off your mire. Tears in these flames will soon grow kind, mix an eye self of the blind. Tears cleanse and supply without fail, and fire the purge your colours veil. Then comes the light, which when you spy, and see your nakedness thereby, praise him who dealt his gifts so free, in tears to you, and fire to me. Vanity of Spirit, by Henry Vaughan. Quite spent the thoughts, I left my cell and lay where shrill spring tuned to the early day. I begged here long, and ground to know who gave for clothes so brave a bow, who bent the spheres and circled in corruption with his glorious ring. What is his name, and how am I to descry some part of his great light? I summoned nature, pierced for all her store, broke up some seal which none had touched before. Her womb, her bosom, and her head, where all her secrets lay abed. I rifled quiet, and having passed through all her creatures, came at last to search myself, where I did find traces and sounds of stranger kind. Here this mighty spring I found some drills, with echoes beaten from the eternal hills. Weak beams and fires flashed to my sight, like a young east, a moonshine night, which showed me in a nook cast by a piece of much antiquity, of hieroglyphics quite dismembered, and broken letters scarce remembered. I took them, and much joyed, went about to unite those pieces, hoping to find out the mystery. But this ne'er done, that little light ahead was gone. It grieved me much. At last, said I, since in these veils my eclipsed eye may not approach me, for at night, who can have commerce with the light? I despair, and to buy but one half glance, must gladly die.